Hey folks, Coach Jeff, and this is the first, or should I say the second, in our series of effort-based training. And this is a very important part of a training program that I think oftentimes gets overlooked. And that is the preparation phase of your training program. And what do I mean by preparation phase of the training program? Before we lay a foundation to our homes, we have to build the road that goes into that foundation. And that's what the preparation is all about. The first thing you need to do during the preparation phase of your training program is a very honest self-assessment. You know, who are you as an athlete? Who are you as a person? Who have you been as an athlete or a person? And where do you want to go? And what are the steps to get there? And sometimes people don't want to do that honestly, and sometimes people want to rush into a program before they have themselves physically and mentally conditioned properly to do that. And that's why I think you have to step back and say, I'm new to this sport. And being new to this sport, I'm a little bit heavier than I would like to be. I haven't done anything in years. I'm not real sure how to get to where I want to go. What's the first thing I do? Well, I think the first thing you need to do is talk to someone who has some experience. You know, whether that be a friend you know who's run marathons or ultra marathons, whether that be an experienced professional like myself, your family doctor, you should certainly get medical clearance before you start any kind of strenuous program and get a really good evaluation of what is coming down the road so that you can prepare yourself mentally for that. Physically, I think it's a lot easier. You know, physically, you can get a health club membership, get on an elliptical, start to precondition your body for the pounding that you're going to experience as you get into a running program. You know, your joints, your ligaments, if you're new to the activity, aren't accustomed to that, and there needs to be a muscular adaptation phase. And there's lots of great ways you can do that. You can swim, you can bike, you can start a very active walking program, you can get on the elliptical. I suggest that you start a weight program, light weights, lots of repetitions in the beginning to strengthen up the muscles that surround your joints and ligaments and support them. So later on down the road, it will help reduce injuries. A great flexibility program is important. Yoga, Pilates, all of these things can help get your body ready for the activity that's going to come in later weeks. And I think that preparation phase of training can last 4 to 6 weeks, depending on who you are, depending on how quickly you start to adapt to the new lifestyle. And kudos for you if you're new and you're taking on this new lifestyle and you're thinking about how you're going to do it. Please start here. Assess yourself. Where am I at? Where have I been? What am I doing? What can I do to get ready to train? And go through a preparation. Lots of cross-training ideas. Lots of things you can do out there that will help you get ready for that. Once you've established who you are as an athlete, and if you're an intermediate or an advanced runner, this is also part of the training cycle. Don't think that I'm just talking to new people, because if you're an intermediate or advanced runner, you need to sit down and self-assess as well, getting ready for your next training cycle. You know, what did I do in my last training cycle that worked? What did I do that didn't work? Where do I think I can make adjustments that are going to help me through this next training cycle and help me achieve my goal? Where did I go wrong? How can I eliminate that? How can I fix that? These are all things that you need to look at no matter what level you're at as a runner or an ultra runner. And you need to do that in the preparation phase of training. You can also start to precondition yourself to get back into a training program. And that may mean cutting your miles back a little bit to let your body rebuild and repair from your last training cycle and getting some of that strength and flexibility as well. I think that everyone, right from the very beginning, right from the moment they decide that they want to make this lifestyle change, needs to get out and make an adjustment to their dietary habits. How do I fuel my training? How do I fuel this new active lifestyle that I'm taking on? Again, there are lots of great professionals out there who can help you through that phase, who can guide you through that. There's lots of great things that you can read. Choose a way that you're going to enjoy, that's going to work for you, that's going to help to change your fueling patterns to make training a lot easier and more successful for you. So after you've done the assessment and you've gotten the basics down, the next thing you really want to do is sit down and write out your long-term goal. Your long-term goal, after all, is what you're into this program for. So you've written down that long-term goal. And how many weeks is it going to take me to get to that long-term goal? Is this a goal that motivates me? Why does this goal motivate me? But motivate me is something that you have to look at. So you've written down that long-term goal. The next step is to write down a series of short-term goals that lead to the successful completion of that long-term goal. Why do you need to write down these short-term goals? Very simply, they are your measurable goals. You know, you really can't put the measurability is the word I'll use on a long-term goal, but you can put them on short-term goals. That's how you track and measure your success or the struggles that you're having along. Is this working for me? Is this not working for me? Your short-term goals are going to help determine that to make sure that you're staying along the path to success. Think of your short-term goals as the yellow brick road to Oz. You need to lay them out, follow the path along the way, follow that yellow brick road to get to that to Oz, which is your A race, and have a great race, all conditions aside. So lots of great short-term goals. They can come in phases of shorter races. They can come in phases of just measuring what's going on with you over a 2 or 3 week period. Physiologically, we change in 2 week periods of exercise. So every 2 weeks, you can look back and say, where was I 2 weeks ago? Where have I come from today? You might, in a rest week, if you have a 2 week on period and a 1 week off period, during that rest week, look back and evaluate where you've been, what successes you've had, what's worked over those 2 weeks, and going into your next base or build phase of training, you can adapt that into your training so you can keep going along this path of success to your A race. So keep that in mind. Short-term goals help you measure your process or your progress along the way to your long-term goal. Is your goal achievable? You know, don't write down a goal that is so far out there that it's impossible to achieve. You know, the last thing you want to do is have a goal that you can't reach. And you know, and this comes in your assessment, in your preparation and the assessment part of your training. Who am I? Where have I been? Where am I at? Where do I want to go? What's realistic? And if you're realistic about your goal, you'll achieve your goal if you put the work in. And lastly, and most importantly, write them down. And write them down in a way that motivates you. Because if you're writing down a goal that you want to achieve for someone else, it's not going to happen. The goal has to be about you. It has to excite you. It has to motivate you. You have to want to talk about it to people. That's the important thing about setting goals and about writing them down. Write it down in a way that motivates you. You know, we start with a dream. We turn that dream into a goal. We turn that goal into a mission, and we turn that mission into a passion. That's the process to success. So think about that. Make your goals realistic, achievable, measurable, and write them down in a way that motivates you. Do you have the right equipment? This is a time to take a look and say, okay, am I in the right footwear? Do I have the right clothing for the time of year? Do I understand my hydration process? Am I going to have the right stuff to hydrate with? Am I going to have the right performance products to train on and race on? You know, make sure you have all that dialed in the very beginning, before you even start the training process, so you can eliminate any of those worries going forward through your training cycle. The other thing is, I tell people, you know what, it's a very good thing to have a form analysis done. And I say that, yes, I'm a bit of a form freak, but that form analysis, if you get it done before the training cycle starts, you start to develop habits of having better running form. Again, you're going to reduce your chance of injury going forward through your 20 or 24-week training cycle. So get that done. Make that a priority. Look at your body alignment. Look how your knees are tracking. Look how your feet are landing at impact. Have somebody go over these for you. Is that a worthwhile investment? Absolutely a worthwhile investment. I would say if I were to invest any money in anything prior to going in to a new training cycle, I would invest that money on having better running form so that I'm going to avoid injury down the road or reduce my chance of injury down the road. Look, running doesn't cause injuries. Bad form does, is something I always like to say. So those are all the things that you need to do during this preparation phase of training. you're about to embark on something that's big. And again, whether it's you're a first timer or whether it's a new goal to achieve that personal best, it's a big moment for you. It's a huge step for you. Take the time to prepare yourself. Please take the time to make an honest self-assessment. Map out a program to prepare yourself mentally and physically to start a grueling training cycle. Write down your goals. Again, short-term goals help you achieve a long-term goal. I can't emphasize that enough. Seek out counseling from someone who's experienced, whether it be a good friend, whether it be a coach. And remember, measure your successes by your effort, not by your results. If you're working hard, that's what counts. If you're going out there and giving it your best, when you go to a race or when you go out to do a workout, that's all that you can ask for. Remember, a 10-minute miler and a 5-minute miler are both achieving their own personal greatness. Your 10-minute mile is absolutely as good as your neighbor's 5-minute mile if you're putting all the effort into it that you can. Be honest with yourself. Make your efforts honest as you go forward. As always, be healthy, train smart. I look forward to getting you started in our next cycle after this. If you have any questions, please ask them. I'll get right back to you, or one of our coaches will get back to you. And as always, be healthy, train smart, have a great day. This is the coach.